In the face of a looming federal election...
A very important budget for the country.
And it's stuffed with...
Money. I got money.
The federal government unveiling a near $18 billion spending spree on infrastructure projects across the country.
Building a strong Australia. Airport by airport, road by road, rail by rail, port by port.
The controversial commuter car park program is back. Receiving an extra $47 million for five car park projects in Victoria and New South Wales.
$65 million of commuter car parks were announced in the Treasurer's own seat prior to the last election in 2019, and then nothing happened.
But the budget's main aim?
It's a carefully targeted budget that seeks to provide cost of living support.
Hotly tipped, a one-off cash payment to the 4.6 million Aussies on income support. Plus, a six-month cut to fuel excise with savings of up to 20 cents a litre as Bowser price hikes bite.
Sudden jumps in oil prices will simply eat up whatever cuts that we see, and therefore the public may not feel like they're getting the relief that they need.
And one for would-be homeowners.
I remember this when Jenny and I were buying our first home.
The government expanding its home guarantee scheme, which cuts the deposit to just 5%, bumping up the number of borrowers to 50,000 with 10,000 spots for regional areas.
We knew that the hardest thing to do when you're buying your first home was the deposit you needed to pull together.
The opposition signalling while it supports cost of living solutions, it questions the longer term vision.
Just 2 minutes to the election being called, and now they discover cost of living is an issue.
This Prime Minister only holds a hose if it's spraying borrowed money on the eve of an election.
So, with the PM chasing a second election win, will these sweeteners be enough?
The slogans are out in force. Peter Van Onselen joins us now. PVO, we know a lot of the positive pledges that have been leaked, but what else can we expect tomorrow?
Yeah, look, that's a really good question. Perhaps not that much, because these days they do tend to give a lot of it beforehand. But this is an election budget. They're behind in the polls. If there's something they're going to do, they might go a little bit harder than we think on cutting the fuel excise. That one-off payment of rumoured to be $250 might be higher. Or the big one could be tax cuts, but that hits the bottom line hard and it doesn't hit people's hip pocket in time for the election. So there's going to be something there, I think. It's an election budget, but we'll just have to wait to see.
Don't forget beer, Pete. They're going to bring down the price of beer as well. So beer and petrol, you're laughing when you get a headline like that. Do you think this will be enough, though, to get them back in the game, given how far behind they are in the polls?
Yeah, I'm not sure it will be. And I'm hearing that they may not go down the path of the beer tax. So we'll keep an eye on that one for you, Pricey. But look, I'm not sure it'll be enough. They were down 54-46 in the polls 3 years ago. They managed to claw it back with the budget, go on to win the election. This time they're down 55-45. And, of course, 3 more years, the Prime Minister's far less popular than he was back then. I don't know that the budget's going to save them, but if anything will, this is their one shot.
Pete, we're forecast to hit $1 trillion in debt, and here we are, we're going to be spending in a budget again. If we hit the point where we just don't care about debt anymore?
I do think voters have hit that point. I mean, the Liberal Party were always the party banging on about the debt and deficit disaster. It was a third the size of what it is now under Labor's watch. It's infinitely worse now. They hope to try to play a double game here. Let debt rise up, win the vote with the public, spend money, but at the same time as that, warn people don't risk Labor because it'll be even worse under them. I don't know whether voters are buying that.
We'll see your coverage on 10 tomorrow, obviously, of the budget. Are you then going down to camp outside the gates of the Governor-General's house to wait for Scott Morrison to come down and call the election?
Oh, it's like a mercy dash, isn't it? We all want this election to be over, but I don't think they're going to call it at the end of this week. They've got one more week before Parliament's due back next week. I think that the Prime Minister's more likely to go on a road trip, trying to sell the budget, particularly if there's some goodies in it, and then call it the following weekend. So we'll see. My tipping isn't always that accurate when it comes to elections, but I don't think
really?
He's going to call it this.
Really?
No one knows that, of course, so keep that between us. But I think the weekend after next.
All right, more unofficial election campaigning to come. PVO, thanks so much.
Thanks, guys.